الرحمن الرحيم وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين إمام المتقين قائد الغر المحجلين مولانا ومولى الثقلين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد. I think I have the اللهم صل على منه انشقت الأسرار وانفلقت الأنوار وفيه ارتقت وعليكم السلام حقائق وتنزلت علوم آدم فأعجز الخلائق ولو تضاءلت الفهوم فلم يدركه منا سابق ولا لاحق فرياض الملكوت بزهر جماله مونقة وحياض الجبروت بفيض أنواره متدفقة ولا شيء إلا هو به منوط إذ لولا الواسطة لذهب كما قيل الموصوت صلاة وسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله يا رحمة للعالمين ألف الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله مدد يا سيدي يا رسول الله مدد يا أولياء الله شيخ عبد الله الفائز الدغستاني سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم عادل الحقاني سيد الشيخ محمد عادل الرباني رجال الله أعيننا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية Our way is companionship and goodness is in the gathering of good people for a good cause, for a good purpose. That's how people benefit. On our own is very difficult. On our own we are prey to shaitan, we are prey to our own egoism, we are confused. Where is that khatir coming from? We have an idea, you have a thought, where is it coming from? Who is instigating it? Is it Rahmani or is it Shaitani? Is it from angelic sources? Is it from my nafs, from my ego? Is it from Shaitan? Where am I getting the inspiration from? Or ideas? That's why we need to be with Jama'ah, coming once a week at least and sitting with group of people and remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Junnah, is protection, because you are coming to what? To a gathering, Naqshbandi tariqa gathering, Shaykh? Naqshbandi aliyah tariqa gathering. This is my gathering? No. It's your gathering? No. It is under the guidance and auspicious. We are saying, starting every suhbah and every dhikr with what? Madad. Support us. Madad Yahu. Madad. We're asking the madad of our Shaykh. Under his permission, this dhikr is established. This circle is established. So you are coming here to this dhikr. It's like a chain. You're hooking up to that chain. And that chain to our Shaykh, and from our Shaykh to his Shaykh, to Prophet ﷺ. So you, it's not something small. You are coming and you're plugging your, hooking up your chain, and this chain all the way to Prophet ﷺ. Sayyidina Muhammad, this is, you know how rare this is in this world? To have that connection to Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So this is why we have to be grateful for these events and gathering. And إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِنِيَاتِ Also those who want to attend now, especially with coronavirus, COVID-19, it's hard to meet physically. But subhanAllah, you know, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ You want to attend the zikr and you go online, inshallah you are also considered to be with, you're also hooking up yourself virtually to that gathering. Because this is not pertaining to the physicality. These are a'mal al-qulub. This is the pertains to the heart. So when you're coming, we're saying rabita tu sharifa. You know, when we recite the dhikr, we say rabita tu sharifa. Connection, the holy connection, honorable connection to who? To our Shaykh. Shaykh Muhammad Adar Rabbani. That's what we're connecting to. from him to Sheikh Nazim to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So that connection is not a physical connection. It's a heart connection. It's a spiritual connection. So therefore, yani for necessity, if people cannot attend physically but they want virtually, inshallah, also they will get the honor of being in connection, inshallah. We are, inshallah, still in Rabi'ul Awwal, the month of Anwar, the month of lights. This portion of Rabi'ul Anwar, the most enlightened Rabi'. Rabi'ul Asad, the happy Rabi'. This is ولد الحبيب ولد الهدى والكائنات ضياء شوقه. He said, is it? ولد الهدى, when he was talking about the Prophet's birth, والكائنات ضياء, the guidance was born. Allah's guidance was born. Allah's mercy was born. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مهبط التجليات الأعظم. Allah's place where the full khilafah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth is deposited is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That was born. وُلِدَ الْهُدَى وَالْكَائِنَاتُ ضِيَاءُ وَفَمُ الزَّمَانِ تَبَسُّمٌ وَثَنَاءُ. And he is giving this beautiful metaphor that because he was born in this time, that age was smiling and being grateful. Even the time he was born in was glorifying Allah and thanking him for honoring that age, that qarn, with the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So alhamdulillah ala ni'ami that we are alive, we are Muslim, we are inshallah lovers of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and lovers of Ahlullah, lovers of good people, lovers of mashayikh, lovers of people who love Allah and His Prophet, inshallah. We hope to be, ya Rabbi, write us from them. And we also, yani, we have to remind ourselves continually, people having issues and having problems, Shaykh. People having difficulties. And as we are, every day seems to be bringing more heaviness and more difficulty. So what's the answer to that? The answer is not more physical distractions. The answer is not more gadgets. That's going to get you more depressed and more in trouble. The answer is to allot a portion of your life, of your time, and sacrifice it. If we say we love Prophet and we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what's the proof of love? Sayyidi Ali? Sacrifice. Sacrifice. Proof of love is that when you give something you love in the way of the one we love, what is the most precious thing we have to give is our time. So we have to learn, inshallah, all of us. And I'm telling this to myself. I'm not saying that somebody who is accomplished, zero time wasting. But we need to have a wird, a daily wird. Just like you eat every day, physical food, we need to have a daily spiritual regimen. And it doesn't matter, start with something small. Especially if you want contentment and happiness and light in your life, you have to honor Allah and His Prophet by remembering them, glorifying our Lord, by making salawat on His Habib. So in tariqah, you have three things. Istighfar, dhikrullah, Allah, Allah, la ilaha illallah. And the third thing is salah ala nabi. We should have Adhkar al-Sabahi wal-Masa' if you're doing the morning and evening adhkar, but also include some salawat and some dhikrullah, inshallah. And if you're following the Naqshbandi tariqah, automatically you are starting with a full package that is designed to contain all of the above that we mentioned. So we start with shahada and up to the ihda, and then you do the dhikrullah, and then you do the la ilaha illallah and salah ala nabi, and you offer it as a gift to your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that becomes your paradise in this dunya. That becomes your protection. That's what's going to save you on a daily basis. And to have that belief that not to leave it as much as one can, inshallah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq and grant us to be lovers, real lovers, inshallah. Once you become a real lover, then no one needs to advise you to do anything. Because when we become real lovers, inshallah, then we don't have, no one needs to remind us to remember the beloved. He's always in your heart, in your mind, on your tongue. Inshallah, Allahumma, Allah grant us, inshallah, for the barakah of our mashayikh. Wa min Allahi tawfiq bi hurmati al-habib, bi hurmati al-fatiha.